Welcome to Straight No Chaser. Some talk shows dilute the issues. We serve the hard stuff. So welcome your hosts, your girl MBZ, Pastor C, Sinbad, and the Chief.
Welcome, listeners, to Straight No Chaser, where we never dilute the issues, we only serve the hard stuff. It's your girl, Am Beezy, and as always, I'm joined by Pastor C.
Yep, yep.
Sinbad, who will be joining us later, and the Chief, who's actually out this week. So, you know, me and Pastor C going POP, hold it down.
We're going to try to hold it down, you feel me?
So, this week's topic is going to be a topic that we really, really, really need you guys to call in on, because I'm sure once we get it started, everybody's going to have something to say or everybody can relate. So this week, we're actually using a new number just for this week. And that number is going to be 626-253-5010. Again, that's going to be 626-253-5010. So when you feel like you have something to add to the conversation, please do not hesitate to dial that number and join our crew.
Yeah.
Or you can join our conversation via chat on Spreaker.com.
Call in. Check in with us, guys.
Yes. So, mama's boys and daddy's girls all over the nation are attempting to balance the demands of their relationship with loyalty to their family or special friends. Tonight's show is all about friends and family, and I don't mean the cell phone and data plan. For all of our listeners in long or short-term relationships, how do your family and friends impact your relationship? How do your spouse's family and our friends factor in? Are they supportive of the situation? Do they like your significant other? Do they give advice when asked, or do they give advice when not asked, or do they enjoy creating confusion? Relationships and marriages are amazing, but they require a lot of work. And sometimes family members and friends can create more confusion than the hussy down the street who's trying to find a man. Uh-oh. So, yes, America, family members and friends sometimes cause you to work overtime. Whichever category your family or friends falls into, we want to hear from you. So, tonight, how do family members and friends support or harm relationships? So again, before we dive in, please, please, please call us at 626. Sorry, guys. I don't even know the number myself. No, I'm just kidding. It's going to be 626-253-5010. So, Pastor C. So, do your family... does your family or friends give advice when asked or whenever the spirit moves them when it comes to your personal situation with you and your wife?
Absolutely not. My wife are off limits as it relates to individuals having the opportunity and the privilege of butting into our relationship. Now, I'm not saying that we don't seek wisdom. I'm not saying that we don't seek assistance or intervention in times of challenge, or even when we're trying to rectify something, a difference of opinions, we do seek to have individuals mediate. However, we don't allow individuals to impose on our relationship, because it's not their relationship, number one.
Right.
Number two, they don't sleep in our bed. And number three, they don't have to walk out the decisions that we make or deal with the benefits or the consequences of decisions that we make. So I don't feel that individuals are entitled to navigate through our lives and share their opinions. That's me.
I agree.
That's me. Now you're dating Amber. I mean, now I answer that from a marriage perspective. How is that when you're dating? Do you allow individuals to impose themselves in your relationship, tell you what you should do, what you should not do, and things of that nature, including, watch this, your parents?
Well, I think that, you know, I think with any relationship, I tell people this all the time, when you move through life, you're going to encounter people with very, very different personalities. Mm-hmm. And it's up to you to decide which of those personalities you go to for certain things, if you allow those personalities to still reside in your life, so on and so forth. So I say all that to say that I am very, very picky about which friends I bring into my relationship.
Okay.
Based on, just based on, you know, I have one friend who I know if I want to do something crazy, she's always going to support me doing something crazy. Mm-hmm. So if I'm in a relationship and I'm looking for some sound advice, I know I'm not going to go to her because she's going to tell me to do something crazy.
So you have select friends for select situations.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Because there are some friends that I will absolutely not allow into my relationship. Mm-hmm. Not because I don't like them as a friend, but because, you know, I just know which personalities to let into my personal business and who not to. So there are friends I don't even bring around my man. There are, but there's also like, I would say two solid friends that I can go to for relationship advice, and they won't be biased. You know, they'll tell me if I'm wrong. They'll tell me if I'm right, but I'm putting the information across in not so good of a way. But I do go to my parents as well, because I do have the privilege of being one of these people in this generation that looks up to a couple who's been together for a long time. My parents take the institution of marriage very seriously, mm-hmm. as I'm sure you do,
yep.
being a pastor and all that.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But, you know, a lot of times in the Black community, we are kind of notorious for not having that kind of institution to look up to. You know, a lot of people, you know, oh, I have my mom, my stepdad, or I have a single mom. And, you know, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, because I've seen some mothers who are, wow. I've seen some fathers who are absolutely wow. But, you know, while I'm in this position in life where I was blessed to have two parents who went through the dating experience,
right.
obviously, before they got married.
Right.
I might as well use that to my advantage. So
okay,
I
now,
do ask for advice.
Yeah, well, and that's good. But you know, I come from a close knit family. Mm-hmm. Now, I am the oldest of six children that my mom had. My family is very, very close knit, and sometimes parents like to impose their opinions and their way of doing things into the life of relationships of their children.
Mm.
Because parents feel like they know best. They've been here before. They've dated before. They've been everywhere before. And so when you begin to live life, they feel as if you need their input.
Right.
And so one of the things my wife and I, we make sure that we do, or we did, we establish parameters and boundaries mm-hmm. in our relationship. And we make sure that we don't impose ourselves in other individuals' relationships
awesome.
Or their business.
Yeah.
When someone begins to talk or talk about somebody else in our presence, we
Ooh,
have a
skirt.
Yeah,
yeah. I ain't hear it.
Right. Now we have a little code. We say our address. We will say our address to remind us that the only business that is priority in our lives
resides at that address.
Resides at that address. And so, you know,
I love that.
Yeah. And so I have this thing. If you did not stand with me at the altar and commit to this marriage, then you don't have free will and free course to say any and everything concerning my marriage, including,
mm-hmm.
watch this,
mm-hmm.
my parents.
Mm.
And my wife and I have established that. Now, I have a wonderful father in love, and I have a wonderful mother in love. I have mm-hmm. some brothers and sisters in love. My my wife has a wonderful side of the family. Mm-hmm. And we all talk. We're very close. We communicate. We awesome. Trip out. However, we don't have a problem with them trying to impose themselves in our relationship.
That's awesome.
And we don't impose ourselves in others' theirs. Relationship, even when there's arguments and disputes.
Nice.
And one of the reasons why, and I want you to chime in on this, Ambeezy.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes when relationships go through challenges and there is a fight or a quarrel. Mm-hmm. Now, when I say fight, I'm not talking about a physical fight.
We're just heated back and forth.
Exactly. Right. Mm-hmm. We do not condone domestic abuse in any right. type of way, whether it's physical or verbal. So I wanted to stress that. Mm-hmm. So when you hear the term fight, if I may use that, I'm only talking about conflict and confrontation. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so we pride ourselves in making sure that we don't get involved, because sometimes when you involve yourself in conflict pertaining to another relationship or couple, they may make up.
Right. But okay. See, that's where I was kind of going, because mm-hmm. I completely agree with that.
Right.
My mom always tells me, You forgive and forget. When you go to your parents or your friends to vent mm-hmm. about your relationship, mm-hmm. you have to remember that you're giving them a database of negatives.
Right.
So it's like you pick up and move on from the situation, but like all they know is you telling them, oh, well, girl, you know, he did this and he did this and he did this. So it's like,
yep.
How that also affects the relationship with those people and your significant other, because it's like, what are they supposed to think if the only time you hear them talk about them is when they're talking about some crazy negative stuff that they're doing?
And there's a challenge. Okay, so yeah. if you and your guy, Amber, mm-hmm. and BZ, and mm-hmm. you do that, you are in a relationship, correct?
Yes.
does your parents know? No, I'm just joking. So if you and your significant other are in a quarrel, or you guys have a challenge and you bring your parents into it, okay? Usually parents side mm-hmm. with their child, usually. And I'm okay. not saying, you know, because sometimes we're biased, okay?
Right, right, right.
I have children, so I'm going to side with my child. Here is the problem. When there is a quarrel, and parents develop their opinions mm-hmm. about the other individual.
Right.
You and your significant other can make up. Right. However, it has developed an impression
right.
in the minds of the parents. And
that they can't change.
Yes. And sometimes people can't come back from what you've allowed them to be a part of.
Right.
And you all are trying to build relationship.
And but they're now, like, no, thank you.
There you
I'm
go.
Cool.
And that's what I'm saying. You know, it's dangerous when we allow people into our relationship, because we can develop and we can move on. We can forgive and forget. But the people who we allowed in sometimes don't forgive and forget. And they will have an all in their heart concerning someone that you're looking to build life with.
Right.
So it's unsafe at times for us to involve people in our relationships all the time
right.
When we have challenges. I don't think it's safe.
So, you know, I think that I definitely think that that's true,
mm-hmm.
especially when it comes to advice that you didn't ask for.
Mm-hmm.
I think that I was blessed to have parents that are, I'm not going to say they have a hands-off approach, but they are very like, they're not going to impose into my relationship unless I ask them.
Okay.
And they raised me. So they know like I'm a hothead. So a lot of the times if I come to them spewing and fuming, they know, okay, this is probably like a dramatic version of this story. So let's calm down for a second. Mm. And honestly, I think in that aspect, it helps me, because sometimes when I'm making decisions, I really do have this bad habit of ignoring every bit of my actions.
Okay.
And I'm solely focused on the other person.
Okay.
When it comes to when I'm mad. So for me, it just helps to talk to somebody who knows me, because it's not necessarily picking sides. Like when I talk to my mom mostly.
Okay.
Because when I talked to my mom about relationships, it was like, I think there's a difference between when I used to talk to her about relationships when I was like in high school and now, because I think that, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but like, once I just hit a certain age or a certain phase in my life, my mom just started keeping it really real. Uh-oh. Like, she just started, like...
Could you handle it?
Yeah, I think I could. And, like, sometimes the one thing that I had